Hello everyone. Today we're going to talk about implementing the language LambdaE, which is what we called the faster version of our language, our minimal functional programming language based on the Lambda calculus. Today I'm going to be talking about first I'm going to describe a bit the implementation of the language LambdaE. This means I'm going to go through some of the files of the homework 4. Then, in a separate video, I'm going to write some examples that manipulate hash tables. And thirdly, in a third video, I'm going to go through some examples of LambdaE programs and how to interact with the test cases, basically exploring test minus hw4.racket. So first, let's go through our new AST, the LambdaE AST. So if you open your homework 4, you can see here on the right, and if I list the files, these are basically the files inside hw4.zip. If you ignore the directory attic, you will see that there's an hw4 racket. That's going to be your submission. Then we have the PDF, the util, and the test. So as you know, the W4 util is where we're going to store our AST and basically all the functions that you can use in your homework. There's a lot of code in here because there's the AST, there's some quote to serialize a given AST into racket code, and then the reverse getting from a datum, parsing that as an AST. So we have basically the code of the previous homeworks implemented here. So let's go through it. And the first thing I want to show you, let's go through the slides, is basically, this is very similar to what we did before in LambdaS in terms of implementation, but in terms of meaning, as you know, it's very different because now our values are a bit different. Now you have numbers and closures, which, if I can recall, is basically a pair. So this means a pair. It's just a notation we use, where the first element, E, is going to be an environment, and the second element is going to be a function declaration. So the way we implement this is with structs. So let's ignore this function definition first. What you have is on the left hand side, n is represented with this struct, which has a single field for value, and transparent, as you know, is just a way to print results. So if I go here and I actually if I do racket and I do require homework 4 util bracket, and now if I do e colon number, I put number 10, you can see that there's number 10 there. But if I remove this from here, I wonder if I can do this. I have to reload it. Now I do require homework 4 dot bracket. And now, if I do add colon number, and I write 10, oh, sorry, I required the wrong file, util, now if I do number 10, I just get this, right? Which means if you omit the transparent, you stop seeing what's inside the struct. So having that transparency basically implements the toString functionality. Okay, so, and then we have this function that just checks if a given value is a value, and as so this corresponds to the actual rule that says a value is either a number or a function declaration. So therefore we have this or, and we use number question mark, and number question mark is defined whenever you define the struct. So So that's basically it. Now we can go to expressions. And expressions are not very surprising. The only thing that is different from what we've learned in Lambda S is that function declarations now are expressions because they are evaluated into closures, as we will see in the rules. But in terms of representation, as basically for each variable, you're going to have a field. So this is going to be the value that it's not represented as a struct. Then you have a variable, which is represented here in this struct right here. And then you have function application. And now is this apply. And as you know, args is just going to be a single expression. And finally, lambda declaration is shown here. Where you have the parameter and the body. There's only one parameter, although it has parameters there. So you can see the same thing here. Okay. So now, that's it.